Hello everybody and welcome to My Summer Car. This game has been so highly requested on pretty much every video I've published, so clearly there's a lot of you who want me to actually play this game as a series. So that is what I'm going to do today. I have only ever played 10 minutes of it before just to get the feel of the game. I don't actually know what you have to do, so I'm going to be sort of learning as I go. It's a totally blind series. Which is probably not a good thing, but it might make it a bit more funny if I make mistakes. But obviously if I make too many mistakes, it'll make it tedious to watch. So I'll try my best to do a pretty good job at it. So first of all, what we have to do is choose the colour of our car. Now it looks like the default is like a whitey grey colour, complete with rust. But I don't really want to go with that colour. In fact, the choice that you get here isn't exactly amazing, but I'm guessing it is the fairly stock colours you could get with the car originally. This colour to me is probably the best, although it is a bit dark. The cyan, however, it's brighter, but it doesn't really suit it. Maybe white is the way to go. I would have gone with the yellow, but it looks a bit more olivey when it's on the car. So, yeah, I think, you know, I'm going to go with the navy blue. It should go pretty well with it. We'll hope for the best. So yeah, here we go. Let's start the new game. It looks like we have to enter our first name and last name. Now I have been trialing this, and it turns out that you can actually use the last name as a username, which means you don't actually have to enter a first name, which is really good, because obviously we are called Daggerwin. So here goes. Daggerwin. Daggerwom. No, Daggerwin. And I love the way it's actually signed to the signature here. And the signature is different every time. It's unique, which is a nice little feature. Anyway, yes, there is a permanent death feature, which I'm going to turn off just because I've never played it before. I don't really want to mess it up. As far as I'm aware, if you've got that enabled and you die, that's game over completely. So I don't want to do that. I don't know if that is the case. It's just what I've read. So I think we're happy with our driving license, although I'm not really convinced by what we look like. That is slightly concerning. But yes, let's begin. Here we go. Now, as you'll probably know from watching my other channel, I do have experience with mechanics. So I do know how to rebuild an engine to an extent, although I do specialise more in smaller engines. So I'm hoping this is going to be fairly explanatory. I did read a quick article about this game, and somebody compared it to The Sims, like a mixture of The Sims and Car Mechanic Simulator, which to me is perfect because I love both of those two games. And I can see immediately what they mean by The Sims. It's because we've got the urine, hunger, thirst, fatigue, and dirtiness on the top left-hand corner there. So we have our personal needs as well as just going to the shed and rebuilding an engine. So we also do have money. I'm not sure exactly what the money is about. I'm guessing it is for parts, as I know myself, rebuilding things is not exactly cheap. We have a beer case. Oh, almost smashed them. We will, we should probably take these out to the garage, actually, because we're going to need quite a few beers. That's it. Drop them from a height. Yeah, if we can put them on the side somewhere without breaking them, then that'd be good. Ah, here we go. I keep dropping them from a height. A bad habit to get into. Here is our car. This is the car which we are going to be refurbishing. Now, from experience in real life, I have learnt that it's not always best to start with the bodywork. It's actually better to start with the gearbox and engine, and I think we have to do the engine in this game. So I am going to rebuild the engine from scratch before we even touch the bodywork, because if the engine's had it, what is the point in doing all the cosmetics? There is no point at all. So yes, that is what we're going to do first of all. Again, been reading an article and it just says the bare minimum of what you need to do first of all, and it seems to be to get the supplies, really. So that is what we are going to do. Oh wow, there are a lot of parts in here, and I think we are actually allowed to build these from scratch. This is going to be a challenge. It's lucky we have some background knowledge here. Lots of different aerosol cans and stuff. A toolbox. Still getting used to the controls. Oh, there we go. So, yes, we are going to be rebuilding some of this shelf today. Or at least what's on the shelf. So, This fly keeps buzzing around me. Go away, fly. You annoying thing. Yes, the beer. Before it gets warm. We can't have the beer getting warm. Let's put it somewhere out of the way. But obviously somewhere accessible, because we're going to need this a lot. In fact, we should probably buy some more beer. This just isn't enough for us. There we go. The beer is happily sitting on the shelf. Did I see some sausage or something inside? I don't know. That must be for the hunger. Yeah, there it is. Is there a cupboard for it? Cupboard's to open. Aha! A fridge. Sausage, you go in fridge. Come on, sausage, you can do it. Looks like someone ran over the sausage. It's totally flat. Right, that is done. There seems to be a lot of flies about, so I'm pleased that we've put it in the fridge. Yes, let's lock up. We are going to be driving away from here. Come on, please. Lock up, there we go. Yep, still just getting used to the controls, because I've only played for 15 minutes just to sort of get the bare minimum of the controls. Otherwise, it would be painful trying to get me to learn how to actually use them. Right, so this is clearly our little commercial van. As nice as it is, it's old, but what's inside? Right, okay. So it's totally empty. I was trying to get into this van before, and it turns out that the best thing to do is do a run jump into it, which seems strange, but it does work. Just sort of go back over there and then run into the door. That's the best way of getting in. Right, it's diesel, because I can see the glow plug light on there. So let's put the ignition on, let the glow plugs warm up. This should aid the start of the engine. Come on. I think I'm clicking it wrong. Let's give it a few seconds. Come on, you can do it. Oh, we almost had it. Yes, it is running. I don't think it should have taken that long, though. Right, so what have we got in here? We've got lights. We don't need lights, though. Handbrake, yes, that can go off. Go off, handbrake. And I've got auto clutch on. You can actually use a steering wheel, but I haven't got it set up for this game. Oh, okay. We're falling apart as we go. That is a good start. Come on, shut door. Right, off we go. Whoa! Okay, okay, right. Better to learn that now than later. Don't worry, I will get better. This grass is very wet. Whoa, I can see a lorry. I think it would be better if I did set the steering wheel up. Okay, so here we are. Let's put it into neutral. And I think I should probably put the handbrake on too. There we go. Let's jump out. This appears to be our lorry. What it is for, though, I have no idea. It looks like a sewage lorry. Why would we have that? We're supposed to be rebuilding engines. Oh, what's this? Chopping block. For when we get angry, we can take out some aggression on the chopping block. We've got a trailer. Oh, it's a tractor. No, it's a tractor. That is going to be handy for something. I don't know what. I'm guessing it is implemented into the game for a reason. But because I've never played before, or in fact, I've never even sort of read a walkthrough, I don't even know what we have to do. This is going to be hopeless. Yeah, is there any other reason to be here? I'm not too sure. There is a toilet, which is good. It appears that to save an exit, you have to go to a toilet. So we need to bear that in mind. We have a jerry can for diesel. We should take this with us. Again, I was reading the basics and it does say to stock up on fuel. So that's what we'll do. But as for what you actually do in this game, that is currently unclear. Obviously, there is some form of rebuilding, as we've seen all the parts. Right, you go in there. Come on, get in the back there. Is there another one or is it just one? Drinking alcohol while using an axe. Seems like a sensible idea. I'm guessing that is... Yes, it is. Okay. Yeah, I think there is just one then. I can't see another one unless I'm just being blind. There could be another. But one should do us for the time being. My guess is that tractor will attach to the trailer. Anyway, let's go. I'll shut the door. Now let's do our running jump into the van. Ugh, there we go. I've tried other ways of getting in, and it's very hard. This door never likes to shut properly. Right, okay, so now we have got that sorted, what we can do is go over to the shop and raid them. That's just what we're going to do. We're going to raid the shop. With all of their crisps and everything, all their alcohol, because we need a lot for this project. At least the mirrors work. Oh, I've just taken over the dog bin. Alright, off we go. How many gears do we have here? At least three. Yep, you see what I mean about it being better if we had a steering wheel? Because when you use a keyboard, it always corrects itself and puts the steering wheel back to the centre. Hmm, I'm concerned that we're going to actually tip this thing over. It seems very easy. And the fact that you can die doesn't fill me with much confidence about going too fast. Oh, and also our thirst is going up very fast. The same with the fatigue. That's probably the stress of driving in this vehicle. The hunger's okay, the urine's fine. Mainly because we haven't actually drunk. Come on, get in gear. Don't tip over. Oh, there is a railway here. I don't know if it's active. Now, a junction. Which way do we go, though? That is the issue. Which way do we go? Well, we have got... is it Lope to the left? Or Raikipoja? Sorry about the pronunciations. Well, that place is closer, so let's just go right. Oh, this road is treacherous. Whoa. Gotta be careful. I suppose if you do tip it over, you've got the tractor to pull it back. Unless it doesn't let you. I'm sure we'll find out, though. Because if we do tip it over, we're pulling it back with the tractor. We'll have to at least try. I feel to be going back the way I came. Obviously, we're not on the same road, but I do feel to be going back the same way. Technically, we should see a train line, as we've just crossed one. Unless I just feel like I'm going back the way we came, we're not actually going that way. Sure, it'll soon become clear. I would change gear, but I'm just so scared about tipping this thing over. It feels like it is just going to go. Maybe it does grip better than it feels. Oh, no, here we go. Train line. So, yes, we are going back on ourselves. That is quite a big drop. I think this would roll very well down there. But we're not going to try it out today. I'm sure it will come naturally one day. If we survive. This road is never ending. It said 1 mile. Or 1 kilometre. To the next place. Can't be too far. Unless we had to branch off to go to the place name where it was showing. Maybe it's a different place which we're heading to. Or maybe I have just gone completely the wrong way altogether. That wouldn't surprise me. Whoa. Gotta slow down a bit here. As tempting as it is to floor it, I don't want to have to restart. It does mean, however, we are using way too much diesel. In fact, we better refuel. We've only got half a tank. We'll fill up the jerry can while we're at it, the diesel tank. But no, nice scenery. I did actually, when I was playing this earlier, just sort of trialing it for 15 minutes to get used to the controls, I had the quality of the graphics set on the worst, and it's amazing when you change it how different it is between the worst and the best. This is the best. And yeah, it was terrible before. I thought there was something up with the game, but then I realised that I had just selected the wrong graphic setting. Now, I have reason to believe that there is a junction or something up here. Oh, I've got to change gear. This sounds too bad on the engine. For somebody who is supposed to be restoring a car, and then we're driving it full RPM in second gear, just doesn't seem right. Okay, I can't see. I don't know if there is traffic. So many flies about, you keep hearing them. Oh, it's a, what is this, just, it's a dual carriageway. Okay, it's not a dual carriageway. It's just single carriageway. I can see a car. I hope I'm on the right side of the road. Yep, it seems to be going the other way. Good, let's try and catch up with it. Maybe we can have a race. Don't die on me, van. You've got to bring our supplies back. I am hoping to start rebuilding the engine today. I don't think there's anything else we need to do first. So, let's just race this car, get the supplies, and then hopefully at least start the bottom end rebuild. Hoping. But it just depends how well it goes, really. If I get angry and start throwing spanners about, then, well, it may be the next episode. But we'll at least attempt it, I'm hoping. Okay, let's not use too much fuel. We have got to be careful. I'm guessing the £3,000, although it sounds like quite a lot, isn't that much at all. Where am I going? Is this the place? Is this the place? I don't know. Let's just see. Let's see what's up here. Well, there's definitely people about. This seems like quite... Aha! Fuel! This is definitely a good place. Let's park up. That is quite an achievement. We've just parked up in third gear without dropping down. This is quite an incredible van. We will turn the engine off. And, oh yeah, we probably shouldn't forget the parking brake either. Do we have to be in the driving seat for that? Yes, we do. There we go. Let's jump out. We'll fill up the jerry can very soon. Hello?
Hei, onks tää nyt se Peräjärve kova jätkä olevina?
Excuse you.
Onks tää, osaks tää mitään
tehdä? I didn't come here to be abused.
Mitä tää tulee tän promosan kanssa tänne riehumaan? Ei vittu, mehän nyt vittu jo.
What's up with you? He's just parked here and he's just... We just got out of here and he's just instantly abusing us. Yes? Looks like someone's punched you in the face. I'm not surprised. I think I should do the same thing. Let's just move away from him and stay calm. Let's buy stuff. That's more like it. Hello to you too. Right, so, as I said, we are going to raid the shop. So let's just, you know, grab stuff. Let's just go for stuff. Hang on, is he automatically charging us? Oh, he's watching what we take off the shelf and instantly adding it to the bill. No chance of shoplifting around here. Coolant. Do we need, actually, do we need 20 litres of coolant? We probably don't. Oh well. It will come in one day. What's this? Fan belt 295. Okay. Chuntering onto himself. What else do we need? Sugar? Yeast? If we're having a cup of tea, we do need some sugar. We'll have some sugar. Yeah, you add it. Well done. Anything else? Nope. Aha! Don't mind if I do. Oh, they'll do well. Two of them. Yep, hope you're getting all this. And some... Well, I've got some sausages. We don't need any... Oh, pizza. You want for pizza? Anything good here? sugar again, that's on the other side, and yeast. Juice, yes, we need juice because we are thirsty. We can't just live on alcohol as much as we might want to. Sorry, I just dropped a penny or something. Oh, it probably isn't a penny though, is it? What's the total? Oh, wow. Wow. Can you do a deal? Is that your best price? Okay, okay. Fair enough. Let's just pay. And then you throw our groceries at us. Thanks a lot. You're not a nice person. We'll take our shopping bag. We'll come back for the rest. We'll put it in the back. Because the can should be in the front. Okay, it has moved. Why do I keep crouching? I've got an obsession with crouching. I don't think we have to crouch. Although, it could be quite difficult to do it without. So we are left with 1,738 somethings. I don't know the exact currency here. I'm sure somebody will be able to correct me. Yes, the beer. The beer is good. That means we have two crates of beer. That might have been quite an extravagant thing to buy because obviously we do need to pay for various parts for the car. I don't know if we do have to pay for everything or if we just rebuild the vehicle as it is. But like I said, I'm sure it will come clear. He's still just sat there. Oh yeah, we've got two coolants. We didn't need two coolants. But like I say, I am sure they will come in at some point. Yeah, we've got a good chance of something leaking here, the way I'm stacking it. But that should do. I'm guessing we're going to have to go back to him because we're going to fill up the can and we're going to refuel our van. Come on, can. Good. So we have got petrol and diesel. We rotate it. I don't know how to refuel this. I think it is as realistic as making is actually remove the cap. The only issue is rotating it to stand up. Aha! There we go. We'll get it close. Do we have to remove the cap? How do we do this then? Ah, there we go. You have to press F. So let's top it up. Somehow. How do we top it up? There we go. You see, I'm learning. Things are going okay. We are, however, getting quite thirsty. So we're going to have to head back to the house and have a drink. Although we could have a drink here. In public. That should do. Pop that back. How many litres was that? 17.8, that's fairly standard for one of these. In fact, they're usually 20 or 25. Do we have a bungee or something? Oh no, we're just going to drop it in there. That would do. Right, back into the driver's seat. Have to run and jump in. There we go. You probably don't have a clue what I'm on about by doing that, but if I was to show you it the way you think is correct, it just doesn't work at all. What's that noise? Let's get this started. You'd have thought with it being running just a few minutes ago, it would have started a bit better than that, really. Oh well. Better not run into that. That would be pretty catastrophic. And there we go. Good. Into neutral. And then out we get. Oh, it's a bus. Diesel again, I assume. Obviously, actually, because we've got glow plugs. How do we... Is that working? Yes. There we go. So this, I'm guessing, is going to be very expensive because it's only half full and it's probably got quite a big tank. Almost there. This game does run very smoothly. Nice to play. Good, there we go. Drop the nozzle. We better put this back in. That would be a mistake. And then close the flap. And then we need to pay, yes. What is stopping us from just driving off? Quite expensive. Thank you. Goodbye. What's this? Slot machine. No thanks, though. We're not a gambler. What is he doing? I'm intrigued by this person. What are you doing? What are you doing? Are you doing something in particular? You're just staring at us. You are a strange person. It's me again. Hello. Whoa, 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 whoa. Careful. What are you doing? The fool doesn't even know how to reverse. He is driving forwards into a building. Well, it shows where the brains are. I think we're just going to leave. Goodbye. Before an argument brews. I think I've upset him, but I'm not convinced. Let's just peacefully leave. Ah, yes, I have forgotten which way we came from. I think we came from this way in front of us. Come on, door. Just shut. There goes the bus. Oh, he's crashed into the bus. Oh, what is he doing? He's going to crash into us. Floor it. He's a lunatic. He is a complete lunatic. I have left a trail of black smoke. Run for your lives. Did I shut the door? The side door? I think I did. At least I hope I did. Anyway, with that excitement out of the way, let's go and unpack and, well, we should really start thinking about the engine rebuild, as that is why I'm playing this game. So, yeah, it's quite a picturesque area. I won't call it beautiful, but it's alright. Aha. This looks promising. I would say this is our turning here. This vehicle has a terrible braking system. Right, so you'd be pleased to know that I did find the way back, and I think we are pretty much there now. There's been a few close calls. I have almost tipped over the van, but luckily it just came back over again, so I was very lucky, because I think if you do tip it over and you're a long way from the tractor, you really do have to start again, unless you want to walk, but it's not really worth it. And if you're walking, your thirst goes up very quickly. Right, so there's our lorry, which means the place we're going to is just up here, our house. And we'll pull into the drive. We'll park here. Gives ourselves some space, and put the handbrake on, turn the engine off, and put it into neutral. Some strange noises. Anyway, yes, our thirst is awful, so what we're going to have to do is have a drink. I don't know if we can have our concentrate, our juice. I'm sort of against having the alcohol, although that is part of it. Where did they go? Oh! What a mess. Why was our belt in there? Oh well. Oh, the oil is too. Or what is it? Brake fluid? Brake fluid, yes. Well, they do need to be outside, really. But we really do need to have a drink. Let's just pile stuff up here. Get some light into here. Good. It doesn't really need to be in here yet, I suppose, but I can't really think of anywhere else to put it. Yes, we're gonna die. Quick! Do you actually die? I don't know. I suppose you would do. Where? I don't want to drink brake fluid. I've put the beers in the garage. I'll have one of these. Although, technically this doesn't quench your thirst, although it is doing. It's alcohol. We should be really having juice. The beers are supposed to be for when we succeed. And so far we haven't succeeded, so we're going to stick to juice. I can't reach stuff. There we go. Actually, I suppose they could stay in there. There's not much point in actually unloading it all. We'll just stick it on the shelf. That would do. But there should have been some juice. I'm sure I bought some juice. Concentrated juice. I haven't lost it on the road, have I? Oh well, I'll have to stick with beer. Sugar, pizza, chips, Oh well, can we eat these? Wow, that has made us thirsty. The hunger is right down to nothing. But they were dry. Very dry. We're going to be completely drunk in a minute. That is the whole reason why I bought the juice. If we have to go back out just to get the juice again, that's going to be annoying. This garage is going to be full of bottles. Anyway, yes. Let's at least make a start on the bottom end rebuild. I keep crouching. Let's first of all move the toolbox out of the way. We need to clear some space, so... The dashboard meters need to be somewhere safer than this. Like up here. Which frees up a bit of space for the toolbox, which is good. Can we open the toolbox? Yep, that'll do. And there is an air filter on the table. It doesn't need to be. Oh, now the phone's ringing. Who could that be? I'm dropping stuff everywhere. The pressure is on. Stumbling through our beer bottles. No, not yet. Maybe later. Go away. We'll take up your offer another time. I know we do need money, but we're not quite as desperate as that. Especially to someone like that who sounds drunk. Anyway, yes, the headlights, they need to be, again, somewhere out of the way. These are pretty much final parts. We don't need them at all yet. We need to have a good, clear workstation. I don't know what's up with all the aerosol cans. I suppose we have just stocked up recently with every colour. Before we get to work, I'm just going to save. And to do this, I think you actually have to save and quit to main menu, interestingly. But I don't want to lose my progress. So we're going to have to continue once again. This always seems to be the most sensible way of doing it. Because obviously if we were to move on to the next job, and then something messes up, or we have a power cut or something, then everything is lost. Because I don't think there is an autosave, which is frustrating. It would be good if there was. Locked in a toilet. The doors have shut. But these doors are okay. Right. So, we need to start building. And it's a shame it's going dark because it would have been better doing this in the light. Do we have a light switch? Ah, we do. Modern technology. Isn't it good? Well, that's going to make engine rebuilding much easier. So this is the first part to our engine. This is, if you like, the skeleton to it. It is the bare bones for what we're building things off. Now I'm just going to put this here because we need lots of space. And the worst thing you can have when you're rebuilding an engine is a lack of space. It's just painfully annoying. After this, we need to put on a crankshaft. There is just one. In fact, I might stay in this crouch mode, it's quite good. Then you have main bearings after this. I have accidentally flung stuff everywhere by moving all my parts about. Now, I have actually picked that up in a bad way, because that would have been easier to pick up like this. Try and rotate it a bit, but... Oh, come on. Drop it on the floor. Start again. Okay. So it's on the desk, on the bench. I think they have actually automatically placed these parts in roughly the right way around, because obviously it makes it easier. Right, which is the front? That's the front of the engine, which means that this is main bearing 3. If I can get close enough. I have positioned it quite some distance away. There we go. And have I lost the first one? Have I lost main bearing 1? Oh no, there it is. So that can go in place as well. Now, these do need to be tightened down to the correct torque setting. I don't know if we're going into the details of having a torque wrench. It would appear not. But what we do need to do is go into build mode. And it is going to require a spanner. How do we know which spanner size? How do we know? I guess I could guess, unless anything works. But I really don't know how you're supposed to know what size we're doing here. Unless, I could have been pressing the incorrect button. That would explain quite a lot. I was pressing undo. That is never gonna help. I don't know if we can torque them. We really should have to. Okay, now we just check them again. Good. So that is the main bearings complete. How would you put your spanner back in the box? There we go. I'm learning as we go. Right, after this, what we would have to put in is pistons. These are our pistons, just down here, piston number 1. Obviously, piston 1 goes at the front, usually, which is here. Let me just try and get it a bit better positioned. Otherwise, this is going to be quite painful. Yep, you've got to get it rotated correctly. There we go. We'll tighten them up in a second. Piston 2. Self-explanatory. They just go in order. There we go. And as I have explained, the reason why we're doing the engine first, before we do anything else at all, is because with the restoration, if you don't know that your engine or your gearbox works properly, and then you go and put all your money into the vehicle, and then you find out that it needs a new engine, that can be very costly, and it can actually really wreck a project, because obviously you spent your money on stuff that you wanted to spend your money on, but not necessarily stuff that you needed to spend your money on. Luckily, that has never happened to me before. I've never actually bought anything so catastrophically rubbish that I've actually lost my money. But there is always a risk. Right, so we need to go back into build mode, and I doubt it's going to be a 9mm. I think it's going to be, well, I'm only guessing. How you? I don't know. Luckily, I'm almost at the end of this episode, so somebody will hopefully be able to tell me what spanner size we have to choose, if it tells you anywhere. But as far as I can see, it's a guessing game, which seems strange. Maybe it says it on a bolt or something. Right, so through trial and error, I have now found the correct spanner. It's a 7mm. I think I actually did pick up the 7mm originally. But no. Seriously, if anybody does know, if it tells you anywhere which spanner size to use, that would be greatly appreciated. Obviously, in real life, it's obvious, but in the game, you can't really tell. So once these are tight, I think what we're going to do is just, I suppose the next job is to stick the cylinder head on. But yeah, we'll be finishing in a second. That is looking okay. It's looking very rusty. In fact, if this was my engine, I would be deeply concerned, because this rust is not good to be in here. All of this is within the sump of the vehicle. So if rust falls off, obviously it should go into the oil filter, but still, it should be fairly clean. Now, let's put that away, and we will go for, I'm guessing, the cylinder head. But I don't know if it's been worked on, if it needs work. Are the valves already in place? I can only assume they are. But before that, of course, you need to flip it over, and we are going to need head gasket, sorry. Plus, it might be easy to put the sump on, because if we've got the sump on, then it can sit level. It just depends if it wants us to put the sump on yet. It might not let us. Oil pan. Okay. So it's giving it a fairly generic name. But that's okay. There we go. So what size bolts are those? Just crouching around the garage here. Let's stand up. We were given legs for a reason. We'll try a 9 again, just to see. Nope. What about a 11? Nope. 10? No. Wow. 12? I'll have to look into this. It turns out that it is a 13. Now, if it does end up being the case that we have to remove this again, then that is absolutely fine. It's not that hard to do. So, yeah. Easy to remove. Now, the rest of them, I don't know. We're going to have to try things out again. Possibly an 8. Maybe a 7? Yes, 7. Yeah, so it's just a series of bolts. There should have been a gasket as well, but I couldn't see a gasket, so I'm only assuming that there is already one on there. Yeah, I can't see a gasket. I can see the head gasket there, but no, I don't think it has gone into that depth. If it has, I will find out later, because the oil will leak everywhere. Anyway, let's just get these last few done up, and then that is going to be episode 1 completed. I think progress has been quite good, especially as it's my first attempt ever. Never seen anyone play this before, never seen anybody write through it. Admittedly, at the beginning, I did read the basic walkthrough, like I said, of what to get from the shop and where to go first of all, but that is it. This is a totally new game. But no, I love it. I think it's pretty good. Even though it can be a little bit frustrating at times. There we go. So there we have our engine. It isn't sitting perfectly level, but what we could do is perches on the edge. Probably not a wise idea, but we'll soon find out. Anyway, thank you for watching. And until the next episode, see you again very soon. Bye for now.